Alright guys, welcome to Catapult Carnage. My name's Chris. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a lovely oak catapult carved from an oversized fork. This is the finished product. We're going to go back now, step by step, how I made this, and then at the end, stick around, we're going to do some shooting. Alright guys, welcome to the shop. So this is the fork we're going to be using. It's an oak fork. See, we've got a crack here, but I don't think it's going to run that deep. If it does, we can still fill it with resin. This fork is roughly big enough of a size for me to be able to fit what I want to fit into it. You can see we're going to make one of my titans out of this piece of oak. So let's get it in the vise and let's get it cut. Okay guys, so our second cut here is much more important than the first cut. We've already got our flattened side here. Now we're determining the thickness of our workpiece. So we're going to want to start, damn imperial measurements, we're going to want to start probably, I'm going to go 20 mil. So we'll go 20 there. 20 there. Okay guys, let me take you over to the bench. So we got our fork. We got our template. Now we're going to trace around this, cut it out on the bandsaw. Right guys, so we pretty much center our design up where we want it on our fork, and then we trace around it. So guys, there's our shape. Now we can cut it out on the bandsaw. So here with our fully cut out shape, which is 20 mil thick, we can now, if we leave enough thickness, we don't really need to do it with this particular frame, but if we had a left more thickness, we can raise the bandsaw blade up, reduce this particular bandsaw, I have to reduce the width to 90 millimeters, and then I can cut three dimensionally. So you can imagine if this was left much thicker, I could have came down and swept out there and bellied in here, and you know, world's your oyster. But yeah, very pleased with that. Okay guys, so we've got our template. It is crucial that we work from our tips down, we work out our sizes, widths, thicknesses, and we work down from that. Okay, so I could cut them sides down on the bandsaw, but because we're kind of working from the tips down, I want to leave the tips nice from the get-go. So I'm going to give myself a nice sanded square edge to work off. And we could now just sand that down, but it's going to be quicker to rip it down on the saw. Hopefully now you can see our cut. We've just removed some of that material. Now we're going to take a small belly out of the handle here. Okay. So now you can see we're starting to take shape. Just gonna check and you guys can see what I'm doing here. I'm just gonna give a quick pencil mark. And we're gonna file to that line or repeat that line on the other side. Okay, so best thing I have found for this job is a file. A good workbench to clamp to, because you want to sort of use the file with both hands. So we've got this clamped, it ain't moving, and now we can slowly start working to our line. Right, so a little tip for sanding. I've got one of my sanding pads from my Linisher here, wrapped around some foam, wrapped around a pencil. So that gives you like a soft circular sanding sponge, an improvised. And this here at 400 grit is really good at creating a nice even finish across your shaping. So from the shaping process, you might have some ridges, lumps, bumps, divots, that type of thing carved into your design. And this form of sanding kind of irons all those out, leaves the finish much more even, misogynous. So I'm just going to continue going over this as I am with my little improvised sander. And this is 400 grit. I'm probably going to go to 800 this here, then 800, then I might give it a buff on this 1000 grit Scotch Brite brush behind me. Great job. So I'm going to give this a sand and then I'll get back to you guys. Guys, so here's our sanded catapult. Now we're just going to apply our finish. Actually thought I would show you guys that as well. That is what came from that. So that's the face of the oversized fork that I cut away. So we're going to apply some teak. I normally like to fully submerge the wooden catapults that I make, and I don't let them soak for a long period of time. I just like to submerge them. Sometimes I soak them, sometimes I don't. I don't think it makes much of a difference. Normally I would, if I wanted to submerge it for a long period of time, I would weigh that down, let it be fully submerged. Whenever you do that, sometimes you can actually see some bubbles coming from your catapult, which you can't this time. But that's going to be plenty. So yeah, I'm really happy with how that turned out. Now we'll just get a rag. Buff that off and then leave it to dry. I like the teak oil because it's thin, so it penetrates deep, it dries fast, and it's cheap. Boiled linseed oil is also quite good, but a little bit longer drying time. I want to shoot this catapult tomorrow. I can always apply other coats if necessary. I used to use Danish oil and tung oil and stuff like that a lot before, but I find they build up over time to like a varnishy type finish, which I don't really like. You know, you could use a poly coat or, you know, yacht varnish, but the oil feels much better. You've protected the wood and you can still feel the grainy. You can still, it still feels like wood. With a varnish, it feels plasticky. So yeah, I'm really happy with that.
All right guys, I'm absolutely thrilled with how this turned out. Beautiful in the hand, lovely and ergonomic, beautiful grain. Shout out to Paul for giving me this oversized fork. Check out Paul's Instagram and YouTube, Paul's Wild World. But yeah, let me know what you guys think. I'm really happy with how this turned out. Let's have a few shots with it.
Okay guys, so this is our maiden voyage. We're shooting 0.6 sniper sling, 22mm to 12mm taper. holds beautifully. I'm really happy with the shaping on this one. I was shooting green GZK, but I found it changed, it became stiffer. I don't particularly like stiff bands. These bands have a nice smooth, snappy release, smooth draw, snappy release. Yeah guys, so that's it. Thanks ever so much for watching. Really appreciate your views. If you like this video, drop me a comment, give me a thumbs up, really helps me out. So until the next time, see you guys later. Eve, look, wolf selfie. Hey girl. Where is the wolf? He's gone. The wolf is gone, darling. He's gone. We see him on the way back, won't we? Who's that girl? Who's that lovely girl? Oh, that's to be a mean Eve.